Conversation are a major part of our social interaction, but are you getting the most out of them? In this video, I will share with you a few tips that will help you to get most out of your conversation. Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of Runway. This is Monday, so it will be named as Meaningful Monday, where I share with you some meaningful things which are really important in our day-to-day life. So for today's video, as you have seen in the thumbnail, I will be sharing with you how to have a meaningful conversation. So without any further delay, let's get started.
Number one is moderate the time you talk about yourself. People spend about 60% of speaking time talking about themselves, which causes the brain to release dopamine and gives a pleasure. But is it a meaningful talk that you really wanted to do? So in this, what you can do is try to ask something about that person, about his story, how his or her life is going. In this way, you are interacting, you are having a one-on-one talk which really involves that person, and in this way you will surely start having a meaningful conversation.
Use open-ended questions. Open-ended questions gives your partner an opportunity to put up their viewpoints, that what they think, put up their thoughts in front of you, which will make you to understand your partner much better way. Now you can use your open-ended questions, like you can talk something which is happening in recent times, and you can ask if you were in that place what you would do. So in this way, you are giving your partner an opportunity to tell about himself or herself. This will make you to understand more about that person. Now the third point is, have patience to develop a meaningful conversation. Psychology says that online conversation gives us a false impression that having few lines of conversation can start a meaningful conversation, which is completely wrong. If you have that notion, just take it out of your mind and throw it away, because having a meaningful conversation takes time, because building a trust for another person is really a bit hard for some people. And if you want to gain trust and start some meaningful conversation, you need to ask some general questions, like just go on talking, even if the conversation is going nowhere, just go on. The other person will have a feeling of trust, which is really important in starting a meaningful conversation. So you need to keep the conversation going on in order to have a meaningful conversation. Number four is, don't just talk about business. Even if you work in the same firm, having a meaningful conversation every time does not mean that you have to talk something about your work. You can pick up a topic which is hot and fire. You can just pick up something from current affairs which will have a common ground for both of you to speak, because you will be having a bit more or less same knowledge about the thing, so you can change your ideas and start a meaningful conversation. So remember one thing, that having a business conversation is something different from what you want to extract from a meaningful conversation. So in the list, number five is, avoid giving unsolicited advice. Now according to Stanford University professors, when you tend to give unwanted advice to a person, the person develops a defensive mechanism against you, and he or she might go apart from you, because everyone loves their freedom. And when you give advice which is really not wanted, you tend to interfere into that person's personal space. So try to do one thing, that listen more and speak less. By doing this, you will be doing a lot of things, that is, you can accumulate more, and you can use those things, you can use those knowledge in some other place where there is really requirement of that knowledge. So make sure that next time when you meet a person, you give them their personal space to think and react without giving them their advice which is really not required at that place. So in this hectic online centric world, try to use all these tips that I really shared with you right now, because these tips will help you to have a meaningful conversation. You can get most out of your conversations if you use all these tips. So my work is over for now. Your work starts, that is to implement all these things in your day-to-day life, because until and unless you implement these things on your life, there is no use of watching this video. So make sure you do that, and
please share this video with your friends and family, because these are the videos which everyone should know about. And subscribe to my channel, press the thumbs up button, give me a big fat thumbs up, and share the video. Comment me in the section below that what are the points which I missed on and what are the points which helped you to having a meaningful conversation. And you should be doing all these things, because these things are completely for free and no one is gonna charge you anything for this. So it was all for today. The link to my social media handles are given on the description box. So go and check it out. Follow me over there. Ask me questions. Until we meet, take care of yourselves and goodbye.